The Dognapper.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jason Salazar, and I'm here with
Jeff Paulson, Eddie Tingley, in this Tingley episode.
The second one we did. Oh, there's Whitfield. Oh, look at that little porpoise of a dog. He was a good dog. So we did this. It was the summer of '94 still, and we did this one. We did it like the week after we finished the first episode.
Probably. We loved that first episode. That was the greatest thing. And I believe you don't particularly care for this episode. I think this is one of my favorite episodes. This is short and sweet. I think it's great. I love the Dognapper. I think it's highly underrated.
I think just because after the success of the first one, and by success I mean amongst the six people we showed, everyone thought, wow, this is great, you should do more. That one was so epic in scope compared to anything else we had done at that point that we're like, oh, we gotta do another one, and we couldn't really think of anything. So we just, at the time I lived here in Morgan Hill, and we went up to my house, and we're like, what should we do? Oh, well, let's put the dog in it. And okay, then what? Well, how about you be a Dognapper? I'm like, but I was Harrison in the first one. Back then we didn't care that we played multiple characters, so and of course we started it off with a nice little dance sequence.
Of course. Same dance moves recycled in every episode.
I think you would kind of, after this one, were the dance moves pretty much done. So it was like,
I don't know what I'm doing. And with those dance moves. Yeah, written.
But yeah, no, I like this episode too, but it definitely, I think out of the first six, it's probably my second least favorite.
Oh my goodness. Which is your least favorite?
Probably the Thanksgiving episode.
Oh, yes, yeah.
Just because of
I think this episode's great. I think it's quick, easy, funny. The most disturbing thing is just, this is the summer before college, and to think I wore those clothes going to college, like that just boggles my mind.
I
wonder why I had never had a girlfriend up until after this episode.
I think it might have been too that you wore the hat and coat when you went to college. That probably didn't help you.
But like the short shorts, and I don't even remember that purple shirt. I think that's purple. Like I don't even remember owning that shirt. It's really scary to watch some of these episodes and see.
You look significantly younger too. Like, I mean, I think we say on other commentaries like, oh, this person looks the same or this one looks slightly different. But I think you definitely.
I love this. By the way, I'm a lawn flamingo.
Right,
that's my disguise. I think it's.
We pulled that out again too years later for the second Christmas special, I believe.
Did we?
When we were in was it the first or the second? I don't know. When we went to Reno. And we went near the Flamingo Hotel.
Oh,
and
yeah,
and you did that. We're like, oh, we haven't done that in years.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, I do look very. We both look very young. I like to think that I've aged well these years, but I look significantly. I look very young back then, and it reminds me how I really have gotten older.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely look older. I think the only thing that hasn't changed is my hair. But St. Francis High School, yes. Oh, this was a big stunt for us at the time.
Oh, yeah.
I remember you literally, like, I remember when I was filming this, he's not going to make it. And you just barely. I really thought your foot, that was it.
Oh, I got a nice pimple going there. Excellent. Still going
through
puberty back then?
I think that pimple's in the first three episodes.
Oh,
because,
no.
Because we filmed all we filmed, like, the first three, like, over the course
terrible.
Of 2 weeks. So,
yeah. I think what I like about this episode, too, is we use a lot of John Williams music, a lot of Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade music,
right.
And it, I remember being so happy because it timed up really, really well with the shots that you eventually edited. And
it's funny, too, because since, you know, then I've obviously re-edited these slightly, and I found when I went to put the music back in that I didn't really need to change anything because it worked so well the first time, like you said, that it still matched even once I made a few minor adjustments. So, I don't know why I leaned up to the top of the door there. That was weird.
Well, you don't know why we did many things.
But yeah, then. I just kind of, you know, we filmed one shot and we were like, that's enough, let's go. So, yeah, this is my old house when I lived with my mom in Morgan Hill. Yeah, there's a lot, you'll notice a lot of weird collectibles and pigs, and my mom was into some, and still is into some weird stuff. Collectible wise, not weird stuff. She's not like a masochist or anything. This was also, too, I have to say, back before I actually attempted to act.
I think you do great. You play evil just fine.
Were we ever going to do like another, like the return of the, there's my reflection in the shower. I think we were going to do like another dog napper at one point, but that never happened, thank the Lord.
Is this still your bathroom routine here with the, I think, don't you make some gesture with,
I'll have to see. I do some second. Weird thing where I go for my teeth.
Yeah.
I've washed my hands and I do this. I don't quite understand. And plus, I probably should have done that before I washed my hands, but.
Yeah, you can also see I'm not wearing a shirt. But
that was like, we're like, oh, let's get, you know, the water on and get you wet. And you were like, yeah, that's great, but I'm taking my shirt off. And I was like, of course.
Because I wouldn't want to get the purple shirt wet.
That's what I love about this, too, is the only part of you that got wet were your feet and your head. Everything in between is perfectly dry. So, the hat was looking pretty good still then.
It was only episode two, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that hat was...
not until we put it in the trunk.
In Devin's episode where they
puppy
just knock Willow Whitfield. I have too many dogs named with W's. Boy, he was.
Yes. What were you feeding him?
Everything. I turned off my water. Yeah.
Yes.
Where's the puppy?
I don't know why I talked like a retard in this whole episode, but I did, and wow, look at that. That kitchen is like the size of my house now, but this is ridiculous.
And this little chase, I love it. And getting hit by the car. I love this little chase.
Right, and then, here's everyone's favorite.
Yes! that's great.
It's so dumb.
Fantastic.
I didn't even overact. It's not even acting. It's just over everything.
We didn't know what we were doing.
Well, you did. No. You were okay.
No, I wasn't. I didn't.
Oh, is this where...
It's all these movies that
there's helped. Whitfield's stunt double, yes. Which has now turned into a Lion King doll because we decided that... we tried to put that Ren doll and everything, too. But,
I didn't know what I was doing either, acting. All these movies is what helped make
this
me...
This was crazy. Actor. I was driving while I was filming. That was very dangerous. I could have killed
and
you.
This is a great...
Oh, no. Apparently the dog napper's name is Jason.
That's a nice shot. I like that shot.
Oh, you slide down. Down.
Yeah.
And then... Oh, you saved the stuffed animal / Whitfield. I was very worried for a minute there. But it was great. Wow, look at... I had a pink collar for my for my male dog. That was gay. And much like every... Tingly at that point, which would have been one, but as we find later, they all still ended up on someone's front lawn.
Yeah.
with a bad fight.
I think this is pretty good for not having a cameraman to film. It was just the two of us filming.
That's right, like we would hand off with each other or just put it on the tripod, which you see in some shots you saw the shadow of the tripod. I think right there I told you, kick me in the balls, because we were like, what should we do now? I'm like, I'm like, just right there. The foot
is mightier than the hand. And that's not good acting.
Acting. This is called improv acting. I think given the circumstances, you did pretty well.
Well, I think I've improved improv-wise as well, but it's just from doing all these episodes, you know, And there's me filming.
But it's your shadow. I mean, you can't really tell you're holding a camera. So.
Yeah, that's true.
And here I go running off as if I need medication. This was all just to the dog running off after me. But that's about as fast as Whitfield could run. Another case closed. It wasn't even a case, really, when you think about it. You just kind of showed up and chased us and off you go.
It worked. Shortest tingly episode, and thank goodness for that.
I think it was the shortest of the first six.
12 minutes?
Oh, I don't even think it was 12 minutes. It's about 10 minutes.
10 minutes? 10 minutes. There's nothing shorter than this, is there?
No, not in the first six.
No, at all.
Anything
after the first
shorter?
Six, after the first six, that's when we get into half hour and 40 minutes.
There's
no way we filmed anything this short. This is the shortest. By far,
yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You're probably right, yes. So.
Oh, he gets a real credit. That's great.
I figured, you know, it's in, you know, respect to him. Whitfield has now since passed for several years now, so, You even make reference here. You're like, thanks for watching the sequel, even though it wasn't as good as the first one. Because even at the time, you felt it wasn't as worthy as the first. But since then, you've grown to love it a lot.
Oh, I think it's great. I think it's better than the first.
It's good. It's a memory. But the next episode will be much better. But that's episode 2. Say bye-bye, Jeff Paulson.
Goodbye.